welcome, welcome all into the glorious presence of the Lord. Today at Blessed Family, we celebrate our heritage because we are blessed to have so many different heritage in our church. We celebrate each and every one this month. We celebrate our Native Americans, and we celebrate our Hispanics, and we celebrate our Belizeans, and our Jamaicans, and our African Americans, and our Irish Americans. We celebrate. We bring ourselves to God. So we're going to get started, and I think Deacon Clegan Reed is going to lead us in praise and worship. Our children have things they're going to present to us. This is a celebration. It is also the waving of our first fruit offering that God has blessed us with. So get yourself ready to offer God praise.
All right. Ooh, yeah. Wow.
You're struggling.
Yeah, it's a simple song. Yeah, la da 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 la. Yesterday, a man stared for me.
Oh yeah,
how can you smile when your world is crumbling down? I said, give my secret when I wanna cry. I take a look around and I see that I'm getting by, and I hold on,
hold on.
Change is coming,
change is coming.
Hold on,
hold on.
Don't worry,
don't worry about a thing.
Hold on,
hold on.
You can make it.
You can make it.
Hold on,
hold on.
Everything
will be alright.
Some people like to worry, some people like to hide.
Yeah.
But if it don't work out, here's what you ought to do. Now just hold on.
Hold on.
Change is coming.
Change is coming.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Don't worry.
Worry about
don't worry.
It.
Hold on.
Hold on.
You can make it. Now hold on.
Hold on.
Everything
is
gonna be all right.
The troubles of life. Down.
When it weighs you down,
just lift your head up. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
The love you see is hard to find.
Ooh, yeah.
Don't give up. Just be strong. Keep the faith and hold on.
Hold on.
Change is coming.
Change is coming.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Everything's gonna be alright.
Hold on.
Won't go away.
Put your hands.
Friends let you down, things get bounced around. Here's a little lullaby we like to sing. And it goes a little like
a little
this. Come on, listen.
La 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 la.
Come on, y'all.
La 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 la.
Hold on. Everything gonna be all right. Whatever you going through. praise the way we praise him. Yeah. If you can't sing or dance, clap your hands. That's what God telling you. You can do something. Clap your hands. We're going to go to our next song. I'm just glad to be here. It's another day that God has made. Let us rejoice.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let your glory fill this place. Let your all-consuming fire,
yes,
fill this tabernacle and purify our hearts. Surround us in this place,
Lord, do, Lord.
Want you to breathe
new
life within us. Send a refreshing love, purify our hearts.
Let your glory fill.
Let your glory fill this place.
Let your all-consuming fire. Yeah.
Fill this tabernacle.
Yeah.
Glorify our hearts.
Surround us in this place.
Surround us in
Surround
this
us.
Place.
Breathe new life. Let's ask for the rain tonight. Let's ask for the rain. Say.
Bless your name. Shower down, shower down, shower down. We need your Holy Spirit to breathe on us. Oh, we worship you, Father. We worship you. It's good to be in your house.
Put your hands out there. Make some noise. Pipe it up.
Give God some praise. Yes, Father. You ain't seen nothing yet. No matter what you're going through, you think it's the end, you ain't seen nothing yet. You ain't seen nothing yet. God is good. I was sitting at home studying some stuff. You know, when you get mail, in your mail, they try to offer you a credit card. And God just let me know that they had that same slogan. They prepared something for you, been pre-approved. Well, I'm like, I was pre-approved from God before I was born. All of us, we were pre-approved. Didn't even know it. When I was out there in my sins, I didn't even know it. I already got you pre-approved. Somewhere you're going to bump into me. And I'm here now. Child from the projects. I always be, why you always talking to the project? That's where I came from. I came from the project. I didn't have no house. We didn't have no house. We barely had food. And God delivered me from all that. I'm like, man, when you look back over your life, sometimes just look back sometimes. God, where I came from and now where I am at now. It's just a good thing to be in God's presence, that he brought you from something foolish, foolishness. And I just wasn't no good. I was bad. But God saved the worst, the uttermost. You could just be dirty, low down. I don't mean he can't save you. Because we all are. That's how it is. But I can't even look at nobody and say, you know, I'm so holy that I can't fall down. Or you're going to do some falling down in your lifetime. It's just that God will save you. He'll help you. If you fall down, get up. Don't lie down in it. Just get up. Get up quick. When our pastor told me, "Why you? What you doing? Get up." I remember when I got rebuked by Pastor Thurman. Boy, back then, when he rebuked you, it's like you're going to die. But the funny thing about it, after he rebukes you, he loved us. And I'm going like, you just got through cutting the you-know-what out of it. And he told me, why are you still standing there? Go, keep moving. And I'm like, dang, but I'm hurting. I'm bleeding. But God loves you. He loves us all. We all are human and we fall down sometimes. But don't linger. Get up. Get up real quick. We're going to have the reading of the word by Master Childs. Get him on over here. It's all right, my man.
Good morning, saints. I'm going to read poems, the scripture poems 134. Oh, Psalms 134. Behold, bless ye the Lord, all ye servants of the Lord, which the night stand in the house of the Lord. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and bless the Lord that made heaven and bless thee out of Zion.
Good job. Good job. Good job, sir. And we're gonna go to the Lord in prayer.
And it's always a good thing to be in the presence of God, to give praises, offering the praise to God.
Do it for me. Oh Lord,
oh Lord,
do it for me.
Yes.
Oh Lord, if you don't do it, it just won't be done.
Won't be done.
So Lord, do it for me.
Yeah, God.
Sometimes I get desperate and I say it like this. I say, Lord,
yes,
fix it for me.
You can fix it.
Anybody know that only God can do?
Only God.
Oh, fix it for me. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Because, Lord, I have a problem that only you can solve. So Lord, do it for me.
Can y'all play that for me?
Lord,
Lord,
do it for me.
Do it for me.
Lord, I need you to do it right now. I can't wait till tomorrow. Do it for me.
Do it for me. I can't wait till tomorrow. Hey,
Lord, if you don't do it, it just won't be done. So Lord,
there we ask.
Do it for me.
Do it for me.
Listen, Lord, fix it for me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Anybody know God can do it?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus, fix it for me.
Fix it for me.
Yeah. Lord, I have a problem
that only you can solve.
Say, Lord,
do it for me.
If you need God to do something, say, Lord,
do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Do it. Yeah. Lord, if
you don't do it, it just won't be done.
Somebody say, Lord,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
Do it.
One more time, and I'm gonna leave it alone now. Somebody say, Lord.
Father. Yes, Father. Yes. Yeah, we do, Father. Yeah. Yes. All right now. Yeah, 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 yeah. 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 That's right.
Because we know you are our heritage.
Yeah. Watch out now. Yeah. Yeah. Everything. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah. Yay. Clap your hands. Yeah. My. My, my. Yeah, yeah. Yes, you are.
You are Jehovah Jireh and the hill of Jehovah Rock.
All right.
None like you. There's none like you.
None. Yeah. Say so. Say so. Yeah. Yeah.
You are Jehovah Shalom. God of peace. God bless you for that. I thank you for my portion. I thank you for my portion.
Yes, Father.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Lord, I ask you just to remember your word.
Lord, do.
Remember the offering. It was hard to hear.
Yeah. Yeah.
In
Jesus' name. Bless your name. Bless your name. Yeah. And the people say, amen.
It's a good Sunday today, saints. God is good today, saints. I'm grateful, grateful, grateful to be here, grateful that he has come amongst us, grateful. So part of our Heritage Month is that we also have our young people that will be presenting. And similar that we did last year, we are talking about our heritage within the body. So they are going to be presenting some of our own saints and talking about the history of BFCC through the saints' stories. So our first group will be Miss Princess Cameron, Princess Kendall, and Master CJ Christopher Jr.
Good morning. I did my interview on Miss Leela. Miss Leela Brown was born on September 16th, 1976 in Los Angeles, California. She has four siblings and is the second oldest. Growing up, some of her memorable life experiences were swimming and lifeguarding at her local pool. She attended 2 years of junior college and graduated from trade school. She gave her life to the Lord at the age of 35 because she felt like it was needed. One miracle that happened in her life was when she was hit by an 18-wheeler and was completely uninjured. Three things you may not know about her is that she likes to listen to podcasts of the Word in her spare time. She wanted to become a teacher, but she realized that she is not people-friendly, and reading makes her extremely hungry. The end.
I interviewed Joan Puckett Reed. Joan Puckett Reed was born on March 24th, 1951 in Rockford, Illinois, in Rockford Memorial Hospital. She has nine siblings, five boys and five girls. She's the oldest girl and second oldest child. A memorable life experience of hers is when she visited Community Church of God and reunited with the Lord. She got her GED from ninth school at Jefferson Junior High. She gave her life to the Lord on September 17th in 1972 because she was lost and searching for something. One miracle that happened in her life is when the Lord healed her husband from stage 4 kidney cancer. Lastly, here are three fun facts that most people don't know about her. She's petrified of rats and anything that may look like a rat. She used to tap dance, and her family nickname is Slugger.
Morning. I did my interview on Mr. Jamar Bass Knight. Jamar Bass Knight was born on May 7, 1973 in Rockford, Illinois. He has two siblings and he is the middle child. His memorable life experience was having his daughter. He got his education from Rock Valley College in Rockford, Illinois. He decided to give his life to the Lord at 14 because he understood how much he needed God. A miracle that happened in his life was how God saved him from the streets. Three fun facts that you probably don't know about him are that he likes to sing, he's a mama's boy, and he likes playing video games.
You like to sing? All right then, amen. How everybody doing this morning? Testimony time again. I want to give a testimony real quick, though. I'm grateful for the saints. You know, Friday I was sitting in my truck getting ready to turn somebody's gas off, unfortunately. But it's what I do. But you know, I've been going through some stuff internally, my own causes. And sometimes you get encouraging words. And this came from Mama Evie. And she don't know how much she blessed me that day. I was sitting in my truck, you know, just getting ready to do my paperwork, and she sent a text. She said, you know, I've been thinking about you, this and that. And she said, I want you to know something. She said, God betting on you. And that right there, man, I went into a deep, I just started crying because I felt that. The love that God bet, because it just reminds, you know, when you place a bet on something, it's all confident that you know it's about to happen. And when she told me that, I just remember sitting in the truck and I just started tearing up because I actually need to hear that. You know, God betting on you to get it right. He betting on every last one of us. That's why we up in here this morning. He betting on every last one of us. And I just want to thank you for that, Mama, because you really blessed my, I was just in that truck. I like, you know, I got to hurry up and clear my face now because I got to go tell these people about to turn their gas off. They're like, you crying because you turning my gas off? Yeah, I'm proud. I didn't want to turn your gas off. I got to do it. But I'm thankful for that, and I just want to bless you for that because that blessed my soul. Testimony time.
He's scaring me. Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
Or I can say, Father, I'm home. Because I've been gone for 2 weeks, and I'm telling you, it felt like a month. I missed you guys. There is nothing like fellowshipping with you guys. And when I'm not here, I really, really miss you. So I'm glad I'm back. I want to thank the Lord for healing me. We both had the stomach flu first. And then he got better, and I kept getting sick. So last Thursday, that pain hit me. And I was like, oh, it's the bad divers. So I ended up having to go to urgent care so they could hook me back up. So I ended up in the hospital again with the diverticulitis. So I am so grateful for that. And I'm just so glad to be back. And I'm scared because I don't know why he's standing next to me. So go ahead.
I just want to thank God for being celebrating our 36 years of togetherness.
Well, over 40.
44
straight.
All together, you know. And I just want to thank God when I see the tree down here, that fell
oh my God.
I'm glad it didn't touch this wonderful building.
Exactly.
In the grace of God, I guess all our blessing and strength held all of it back.
Okay.
I didn't get the job, but that's okay.
That's all right.
God hired me and said, you keep on pushing.
Amen.
I believe all that.
Anyway, I had to come to the tree. I also have to ask you guys to keep my daughter from another mother, Patrice, in prayer. Today's her birthday, but she's spending her birthday at the hospital with her mother that gave birth to her because she has to have her ankle amputated today. So you guys keep her in prayer. Diabetes ain't no joke. We all got to take it serious when we hear it. So just keep Patrice in prayer for me. Thank you.
I got to stand and thank God for that. I got to stand and thank God for the word that's in this place. You guys heard Pastor Hallie say that, you know, a lot of times after service, people tell her that's good word, that's good word. I was one of those people. But she also said, it's more than saying good word. The word's got to get in you. I have been struggling since November. Like Finney said, some personal issues. And I wasn't right. But I always heard the word. I was in my word, but I wasn't letting the word in me. See, God can't correct you if you don't let him in. I could read the word all day, every day. I could recite scriptures all day, every day. I can tell you. I made a decision November 24th last year that I needed to be better, not only for me. I got kids, I got saints, I got those that are with me that want me to be better. I need to be better for y'all. I wasn't a 100% horrible individual. I just wasn't doing everything. I wasn't living the godly principles that I have been taught. November 24th last year, I decided not drinking anymore. I wasn't a raging alcoholic, but I got to the point where I was accepting. I would say I work 9 to 5, 8 to 5. At 5 o'clock, I can have a drink if I want. I deserve it. Why? Why? So I said, I don't need that. Instead of drinking, I started getting in my word and asking God to get in me. That has done so much for me. I can see clearly now. I can see the mistakes that I was making, that I was saying it's okay that I made that mistake because I'm a God-fearing individual. I'll be at church on Saturday, Wednesday, and Sunday. What good is it doing you if you're in here and you're not allowing God to work on you? Do not. And I want the younger generation to get this. It is a whole lot more than just being in church on Sunday. Do not be a SOS. Don't be a Sunday-only saint. You need to work. You need to do the work and let God work on you. I'm standing here today because my parents are here. I didn't do that. I didn't do that. God did that. When God spared my father's life, he did that for me. These are all examples of reasons and rationales why I need to be better. I'm sorry that I wasn't as good as I needed to be for y'all, but you can guarantee. You can guarantee I am better today. I will be better tomorrow, and I will be better there on the fourth because I let him correct me. Pastor Howley, thank you. Thank you for our talk after that service. I want to be better. I thank you, Lord.
I have to start off by saying the Lord is my shepherd. I won't want for nothing. He has been opening doors since I've been a member here that no man can close. I want to start off by giving this queen right here, my mom Thompson. She blessed me with this garment. And I want to thank this beautiful mother. This beautiful example for me trying to be a good mother. I will always, on Heritage Day, I will always wear this in remembrance of you. So I love you, and I just wanted to come up here and tell you guys how blessed I am just to have a special garment on today by a wonderful mom. Thank you.
I am so grateful to be here this morning. I'm so happy to be walking that door. I just thought I was wanting to run when I get to that gate. But I'm glad to be here, and I'm grateful to have you guys praying for me when you were praying. Even though my sister, she went with a smile. And it's hard, though. But anyway, I'm just grateful to be back in the house of the Lord. It feels so good. And I'm not talking about any house. This house here, this house right here, it have brought me so many blessings. But I'm just grateful to be back. Very excited. And I'm getting there. I'm a little weak. I have my little days, but it's going to be all good because he did it. And he was there with me every step of the way. God was there. He was there. He was there with me. He never left me, and he had promised he'd never leave me. He was there, Lord, and I want to thank him. Because that journey wasn't easy to do, to see your sibling die on you. But she did have a smile on her face. And I'm just grateful. I'm grateful that she's with the Lord now. And it's going to be all right. And I'm going to be stronger. And what I want to say to each and every one of you, I love each and every one of you guys. And I'm grateful to have you in my family. Okay? So thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, saints. Driving here, looked over to the mountain range. That was beautiful. And as Deacon Finest would say, I think it'd be uncivilized not to mention God's beauty wherever you see it. And it just reminded me that it was storms that produce that beauty. So whatever we're going through, whatever storms may come our way, there's always, if you just hold on, beauty at the end. I thank God. November might have been Chris's last day, but April of last year was my last day of drinking. And my I didn't say I stopped eating. I'm working on that part. But I thank God that he's right. You commit to God. He commits to you. You want him to move. You move. It's not that he's not moving for you. It's you just in the wrong place. You didn't go right when he told you to. You went left. You want to see the beauties of God? Get the scales off your eyes. Get the plug out your ears. Hear what the word says. See what God has done. And thank him for each and every last one of the beauties that you see. And most beautiful thing, it wasn't the mountain. Most beautiful thing that I've seen from God is his people. This is the most beautiful thing here. When I need to see something, I know that there's somebody that say, did you stop and take notice what God has done?
I'm back. So we will have a couple of more of our presentations.
We will have Princess Sierra, Master Ralph, Master Francisco, and Master Charles.
Good morning. I'm going to be doing my presentation on Miss Justice. Justice Renee Cochran was born October 20th, 1994. She is the oldest between her and her brother. A memorable life experience she had was that she's glad nobody rushed her to become an adult, and she got to stay a kid for as long as she wanted. She graduated from the University of Wisconsin with a bachelor's degree in business. Before she moved to California, she knew she wanted God a part of her life. She just didn't know how to navigate that path, but she does have a clear path now. Although she is still learning what being saved means, at least she is learning from the best at Blessed Family. She is happy she is getting to know him on a level she wasn't on before. When she first moved here, she wasn't in the best place mentally. She was battling her darkest thoughts. She was lost, scared, and had a lot of different emotions while she was trying to get herself together and better. Her miracle was the love of the saints. God gave her the family she never had. Three things most people don't know about her is that she's left-handed, her fingers are double-jointed, and lastly, she is teaching herself how to code.
Good morning, Best Family Covenant Church. Today I'll be talking about Andrew Bryan, who was born in Jamaica the 6th of July in 1975. He has 14 siblings, and he's the youngest, and the memorable life experience he has had is he got a diploma in plumbing, and he gave his life to the Lord at 18 because he grew up in church and feared the Lord, and a miracle that happened in his life was he witnessed healing in his body. And three fun facts most people don't know about him is that Andrew loves movies, cooking, and playing and watching cricket, which is a sport similar to baseball.
I did my report on Miss Dana, but her full name is okay. I did my report on Miss Dana, but her full name is Dana Williams. Miss Dana was born on July 21st, 1978 in Los Angeles, California. Miss Dana has two brothers, which she is the oldest of the three of them. A memorable life experience is in Miss Dana's life is that she won a spelling bee, which was important to her. Miss Dana's education is that she is a nurse. Miss Dana gave her life to the Lord when she was 18 years old. The reason is because she wanted to get closer to God. A miracle that happened to Miss Dana is that she had signs of a heart attack, but it turned out she was okay. Three fun facts you may not know about Miss Dana is that she likes dancing, likes to ride dirt bikes, and zip lining.
Microphone today.
sure we can hear you.
Good morning, Saints. Today I'll be talking about Mr. Jimmy D. Craig. He was born in Greenwood, Mississippi. He has 9 siblings, 7 boys, 2 girls. He was the 5th child of the 9. One of his most memorable life experiences was working with his grandfather. His education was high school. He gave his life to the Lord August of 1988. A miracle that happened in his life was being saved. And 3 facts a lot of people do not know about him is that he was a military vet, he served in Vietnam, and honorably discharged.
Okay. Announcements for this week. Midweek service is Wednesday at 7 p.m. Heritage Sunday is today during morning worship and word. Heritage meal available following service. The first fruit wave offering is today. You may still get your first fruit offering in during the wave offering. Saturday morning prayer is 6:30 a.m. Upcoming February birthdays, Mr. Jimmy Matt Craig, February 27th. This week's Bible reading, we have the devotional, and they're out there in the foyer, devotional journal, In His Steps. We start reading that we've already begun. The floor is today, Mr. Javon Walker. Next week, Mr. Javon Walker. Cleaning this week, Ms. Sonia Gray. Following week, Mrs. D. Jeffries. We definitely want to remember the prayer list, our pastor, and each other. The Lent devotional books are available in the large foyer, and we'll replace readings for each week. I've been reminded to let everybody know there's the play going on at the Los Angeles Wilshire E-Bell. There's the huge sign out there in the front. Tickets are still available. 2 shows, Saturday, April 22nd at 2 o'clock and at 7 p.m. God's trying to tell you something. If you want tickets, they are still available. $65 for the matinee and $75 for the evening. And there's more information in the back there. And we have a thank you card here. The blessed women of BFCC. Words cannot express my gratitude. Thank you for blessing me to attend the BFCC Women's Retreat for 2023. This is truly a dream that has come true. All of you hold a special place in my heart. I will always remember your generosity. Love, Sister Lisa Harper. From Sister Lisa. So she's gonna be on the bus for Palm Springs. The next voice you hear is Pastor Wendy Rose Howlett. Oh. No, I don't see it. Hang on. Here we go. My mistake. Additional announcement, 2023 BFCC Women's Retreat. The sign-up sheet is out in the foyer. Information and the price is on the sheet. So, yes, indeed. We caught that.
Amen. 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 God is so good. It is a blessing, if you don't know, to belong to the Lord. Don't let the devil, your mind, your emotions tell you anything otherwise. God loved you so much that he sent his own son. Actually, he sent himself in his son so that he could reconcile you back. I read something and it was saying that God so wants to be in a relationship with us that he goes out of his way to be in a relationship. And I like in our journal that we're reading for Lent when it said Jesus moved into our neighborhood. Oh, I bless his name this morning. So we are going to prepare for our morning offering. I've already welcomed you and those that are watching by Facebook or YouTube. We send blessings out to you. May the Lord our God be with you. So first we're going to do our regular offering, and then after that we will be doing our wave offering. So ministers, after the regular offering, if you can meet toward the back so we can bring in the wave offering. Also, if you have not gotten your first fruit offering in, wait till we bring the basket in for the wave offering. Amen? Amen. It is because the Lord has been so faithful to us. It is because he is Jehovah Rapha and Jehovah Jireh. It is because he is Jehovah Shalom that we as a people, we set aside the blessing we are expecting for this coming year. And we raise that to the Lord because he has been so good to us. So as the ministers bring the first fruit offering forward, let some people get seated. Once they come forward with the first fruit offering, Reverend Patrick Clark will lower the offering, and at that time we will allow those of you who still need to participate to bring your offering up. And if you will, if you have your Bible or your Kindle or your phone, whatever, we are going to be reading as a congregation Psalms 113. If you can sound the celebration horn, and then ministers come forward. Come up so you'll be there. Father, as we come before you now, we come before you with open and willing hearts. We come before you with great expectancy. We come before you because you are our hope and you are our stay. We want you, as we give this offering to you, to bless it in the name of Jesus. Amen. If you will stand to your feet if you're able and you need to bring your offering around, please do it at this time, and then remain standing and have Psalms 113 prepared so that we will be reading it in unison as a body. The children of Israel were commanded when they were in the wilderness to bring an offering before they were blessed with their crops and their fields and with the produce, to bring it in expectation of what God was going to do. And this is what we have chosen as a people of God, because God has always been faithful. And I'm sure I have many witnesses. Every time we bring our first fruit offering, he supplies the entire year for us as a people. So now if you have Psalms 113 in front of you, I have King James, whatever you have. We're going to read verses 1 through 8. Praise you the Lord. Praise, O you servants of the Lord, praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth and forevermore, from the rising of the sun until the going down of the same. The Lord's name is to be praised. The Lord is high above all nations, and his glory above the heavens. Who is like unto the Lord our God, who dwelleth on high? Who humbleth himself to behold the things that are in heaven and in the earth?
He raises up the poor out of the dust and lifts the needy out of the dunghill, that he may set him with princes and prince of his people. Amen. I'm going to ask Reverend Holland if you would say a blessing, a prayer, as we once again lift our offering up to the Lord God.
Father, we come before you with hearts of gratitude.
Yes.
We know that it was you who gave the power to gain this wealth. This is your increase.
All right.
We bless you with
this. Yes,
increase,
yes.
We worship you with this increase, Father. This thing that you've done at this time, in this generation, we bless your holy name. Ask you to receive it, Father.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank the Lord for his increase that is coming, because he is a faithful God. This time we're going to have a musical interlude, and then Reverend Patrick Clark will be coming with the word of God this morning.
No, I'm sorry. We have our children. Again. They'll never pass.
Jordan and Princess Aaliyah. Topper.
I will be interviewing. I interviewed Deacon Cleagan Reed. Deacon Cleagan Reed was born May 2nd, 1954, in Detroit, Michigan. Cleagan has five siblings, and he was the middle child out of those five siblings. His most memorable life experience was growing up and playing baseball with his dad. Deacon Cleagan gave his life to the Lord in 1973, said he was bad and needed the Lord to save his life. He graduated May 23rd, 1984 in Rockford, Illinois, and later became a certified CCHT in Los Angeles, California. A miracle in his life was when the Lord healed him from kidney cancer in 2001. Three fun facts most people don't know about Deacon Cleagan is he can change a baby's diaper, he cleans the house all the time, and irons his own Sunday shirts. Deacon Cleagan Reed, I love listening to him pray and sing. He is very kind and always willing to help others. Deacon Cleagan loves his children, and he always has babies in his arm. He takes care of his family, and he's a great man of God.
I did my report on Maquinta Clark. Maquinta Nicole Clark was born in Los Angeles, California on March 10, 1982. She has two siblings, and she is the oldest among them. She grew up going to school in Los Angeles and Inglewood school districts, and she graduated from Inglewood High School. She gave her life to God because she was missing something in her life, and God was the only one who could fill it. And the miracle that happened in her life was when God gave her a second chance at living and healed her body. Three fun facts about her is that she's creative, she likes to joke around, and she likes to go to plays. I chose McClinta because she is a fun and loving person, and every time you see her, it makes you smile and makes your day better.
I interviewed Mom Thompson. But Nora Ethel Thompson, aka Granny B, was born September 25th, 1932. Back then, movies were a quarter, gas was 10 cents a gallon, and you could get a brand new car for $610. Granny B is the second oldest of six siblings. As a child growing up, she remembers listening to the Country Squire band. At the age of 9, she gave her life to the Lord. And in 1990, the Lord healed her body of colon cancer. A few things you may not know about her is she enjoys gardening. Her favorite flower is a rose. She loves to listen to B.B. King. And she makes homemade dinner rolls from scratch. I chose Granny B because she is nice, she gives the best hugs, and she always encouraged me.
Interviewed Miss Margot. Miss Margot Levette Hallett was born November 24, 1953 at 1124 in Rockford, Illinois. She is the oldest of one brother and one sister. One memorable life experience for her was learning how to play the violin. She got an associate's degree, then went on to do podcasting. She gave her life to the Lord around 1976. Her sister, Miss Thomasine, found a church, and she went on and on about it. Miss Margot came to see what it was all about. She indeed found out that it was all that and more. She then gave her life to the Lord. A miracle that happened in her life was working at FedEx for more than 26 years. She started her podcast and became the co-host with the person that taught her. Most people don't know that she loves to have fun. She likes to dance and laugh. She likes food and is up to try almost anything. Lastly, but most importantly, she loves her life in Christ. That's why I love her. She's not shy to talk about how the Lord has helped her in life. She's always been there for me and is always complimenting me on my outfits. Thank you.
Still chose me. How can it be? Every scar, every flaw, you see it all. You still love me, yeah, in spite of me. Every T, I don't dot every I,
more flaws than a little, and I messed up a thousand times. I don't always commit. Sometimes I give up way too quick, and then I get tired of trying to run away from who I am to who I wanna be. Some days are better than others. I can be up and I'm down, but beyond my mistakes, I'm found in your grace, and this one thing will never change. You still love me in spite of me. You still chose me. How can it be? Every scar, every flaw, you see it all, you see it all. You still love me, oh, in spite of me. I'm stubborn at heart, to put up a guard, do it all by myself. I won't ask for help, but sometimes my mouth is smart. I can be insecure, counting other people's blessings, I never stop to notice what I got. Some days are better than others. I can be up and I'm down, but beyond my mistakes, I'm found in your grace. This one thing will never change. You still love me. Woo! In spite of me, you still chose me.
You still chose me.
How can it be?
How can it be?
Every scar,
every scar,
every flaw, you see it all, you see it all.
Never gave up on.
Saints, aren't you glad that we have a God that don't turn his back? We're not going to make all the right choices, but he won't turn his back on you. Because he already said he'll never leave you or he'll never forsake you. I just bless you this morning, Saints, for being in this house. What is God? God is doing something in this place, and I'm just glad I'm a part of it. I'm glad I'm one of the chosen. I'm glad he picked me out of all these people around the world. I'm just grateful this morning, Saints. God is good. I'm grateful to be in this house. I'm grateful to be in front of you guys once more and again. I thank the Lord for keeping you guys from Sunday to Sunday, from Sunday to Wednesday, from Sunday to Saturday, whenever we gather. I'm glad we didn't get no bad news. I'm grateful this morning. Tell God, I give him the praise. You know what I'm saying? It's good to be in the house. I don't want to do a lot of moving because I don't want to deal with the camera running, but I'm grateful to be here this morning. Can I just talk for a minute? I'm just going to talk for a minute. I thought about the song, when I think about Jesus and what he has done for me. Now I'm not going to dance, but I can stomp my feet and I can clap because he's been good to this boy over here. He's been good to me and he's been good to you. So I'm blessed with this morning, Saints. But before I get into my word, God is good. And like I said before, I'm so grateful that I'm a part of this. Every time when either one of the ministers come and bring the word, I'm glad I'm here to receive it. I'm glad I'm here to do what the word says. Like Pastor Holly said on Wednesday, I'm here to listen to obey. That's what I'm here for. And say something grateful this morning. And, you know, I just want to hold everyone up. It's getting late. I'm just not going to be long. I'm not going to be like, you know, Reverend Lack and say he's going to be strong. I'm not going to be long. But you know, if you could stand and for the reading of the word. You know, Sister Joyce is going to read. It's in your handout.
Now the Lord had said unto Abram, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will show thee. And I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse him that curseth thee. And in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed. So Abram departed as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him. And Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. And Abram took Sarai, his wife, and Lot, his brother's son, and all their substance that they had gathered, and the souls that they had gotten in Haran. And they went forth to go into the land of Canaan. And into the land of Canaan they came. And Abram passed through the land unto the place of Shittim, unto the plain of Moreh. And the Canaanite was then in the land. And the Lord appeared unto Abram and said, unto thy seed will I give this land. And there builded he an altar unto the Lord, who appeared unto him. And he removed from thence unto a mountain on the east of Bethel, and pitched his tent,
having Bethel on the west and Hai on the east. And there he builded an altar unto the Lord and called upon the name of the Lord. And Abram journeyed, going on still toward the south. And there was a famine in the land, and Abram went down into Egypt to sojourn there, for the famine was grievous in the land. Amen.
You can bow your heads. Father God, I thank you for just being in your house this morning. I already thank you for your spirit. We thank you for the kids. And we thank you for your testimonies. Thank you for the prayers of the saints. Thank you for the praise team. Giving the honor and praise is due you this morning. In your son's name, amen. You may be seated. We all know about Abraham. The Lord told him to get away from your country, from your kindred, from your father's house, to a land I will show you. But you know, since I was thinking, the Lord had it was those like kindred, your father's house, those were like strongholds, Pastor. Yeah. Because you know how families are. Right. They'll get to you. They tell you, well, this is what I want to do. Want you, you know. Yeah. That's a stronghold. Right. Yeah. So the Lord had to get him away from them. Because, right, you know, they whispering in the ear, no, you shouldn't go. Yeah. You should stay here with us. You know how some of our family did when we came out here. They came out, they was whispering. Are you sure you're making the right? Are you sure you're making the right choice to go? Yeah. I'm making the right choice. It's the right choice. And guess what? He said, I will show you a land flowing. He just went. He just obeyed. Now, the Lord told him what he was going to do. He said, this is what I'm going to do for you. I'm going to give you all this. Before he even seen it. Says he would bless you on your obedience before you even see it. Now, if he asks you to move, just move. The blessing is coming. Now, if he show you beforehand, you ain't going to move. Because you got the blessing. Yeah. No. Move first. Yeah. Blessing come later. Yeah. It's not vice versa. Because right. You already know. He already know what the human people. He already know what we'll do. Yeah. If I tell you, I'm going to bless you, Kathy.
Yes,
I'm going to give you some money right now.
Yes.
And whatever you have planned with that money, you ain't going.
Nope.
You already know where it came. I already got it now.
Exactly.
No. Blessing come. Get him the praise.
Yes, now.
Before. Not after, no. The praise is going to come after what he's blessed you with.
Yeah.
So Abraham went, took his son, took his nephew, took his wife that was barren. Now I read in chapter 11, they were building this tower. I had to read the whole chapter. They're building this tower, Tower of Babel.
Yeah.
All the way up to the heaven. Yeah. I'm like, this fool's is crap. I mean, that's what I said to myself. Finally. They will build a tower all the way to heaven. But when I read it, it wasn't like that. Whatever they put at the top, it was considered pointing at heaven. So the Lord came down and looked, like these fools, they trying to build it in one language. You know what the Lord did? Well, if y'all want one language, all y'all speak the same language. Babel. They all spoke the same language. You couldn't understand them and scattered. Then when you read down, that's when the Lord told Abram, he took get away from your country, from your kindred. Because they building a tower, what is y'all doing? But so he had to pull him out of that. He wanted to show his glory. So he used Abram to show his glory. He had to move on. So I'm gonna move you over here. You're gonna do all this. He told him you're gonna be the father of many nations. And I thought the Lord had said, Abraham birthed a nation. Families came out from him. And he said, all the families of the earth will be blessed. All your families will be blessed. One man's choice to move on. All your families will be blessed. Your cousins, your aunties, your uncles. One man's choice. Bless the whole family. Now he had to get them away from him, because when he had to get them, I put in a bullet. He had to be established.
Yes.
When the Lord appeared to him, when you read down, he said the Lord appeared to him. He was established right there. The Lord came down and appeared to him. I said he had to get established first. Exactly. He had to move on. He had to get away. The Lord had established him, because he going to go back and get his family. Why does family need prayer? And he wasn't there at that time yet. But you know what? Now that he's established, he can go back and pray for his family now, saints. That's why he pulled some of you out of your, had to get away from your family to get you right. Because your family is going to need you. Your family is going to need you, saints. You could bring your family along. Brother Chris came, mom and daddy here. He met Aletha. Now Chris' family is here. So you know, you got to get right first before your family can come. You can't be the same like you was in the streets. They don't want to see that. They want to see a whole different person in you. They want to see that light, like what changed you? Why you don't do what you used to do? They want to see what changed you. They don't want to see what you still doing the same thing. Why you going to church then? I'm telling you what they're saying. That's what they think. Why you going to church and you still the same person like you was on the street? They don't need to see that. I said, well, you're right. He got to get established first. He had to move him, get him established, so he can go back and get his family. Because he had to, he had to bless his offspring. Now, Sarah was barren. No kids. The Lord told him, you want to have some kids. Sarah laughed when you read on in the chapter. What? Let me tell you something, saints. God can do the impossible, the possible to the impossible.
You're right. True.
You're right. He can do that. Now, you might think he can't.
Right.
That's it.
Just because it's you.
It's you.
That's your natural thinking.
Yeah, that's right.
But give the Lord a chance.
Yeah.
Let him do it.
Yeah.
Give him a chance.
Just give him a chance.
Let him do it.
That's right. Let him do it.
You know what you're going to say?
What?
When he does it, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Now you weren't saying that in the beginning, but now that you see he done it, now you can say, well, thank you. He did. This is what the Lord did for me. That's what he did for Abraham. Barren. She was 90. He was 100. 100, I mean. He was 100. She was 90. Having kids.
Wow.
The impossible. Now, I don't have no kids yet, but you know what? I believe the Lord. I'm established. I believe him. Because if he do it for Abraham, he could do it for me. Now, it weighs on my wife. I already know that. But you know what? God can do all things. She's going to birth my child. Because my pastor prayed a long time ago. And I'm still standing on that. She said, you're going to have a boy. And that's what we're going to have, a boy. I ain't going to be wavering. I'm rooted and grounded. That could be established. I'm rooted and grounded. So if anything happened, I might lean, but I'm not going to fall over. I'm still believing on that. Abraham believed God.
Right.
And it was what counted for righteousness.
Right.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Counted for righteousness.
Yeah.
Lord, I believe you.
Yeah.
And you are righteous.
Yeah.
So, saints, when the Lord asks you to move, move.
Yeah.
Blessing is coming.
Yeah.
Look what he told Abraham. I'm going to do all this. I'm going to give you this. He did that. Now, Abraham lied to Pharaoh by Sarah being his wife. You can make some bad decisions, but he will cover you.
Yeah.
He said, well, you made it back. Come on. Get back on track. Get back on track. Get back on track. Get back on track. Now, you can't do that. But saints, God is still with you. He's in you, and everything is possible. Now, I want you guys to believe that. He's in you, with you, and everything is possible. So don't doubt God when he tell you, when he whispers something in your ear, Sister Margo, well, do this. Don't you say no. Oh, you can't. Why not? Why can't you do it? You are in the image. He gave us that same power to walk on water, make water into wine. We got that same power. He already said that. We're raised in the image, so we got that same power to do everything that he could do. Ain't nothing impossible. But if he did it, we could do it. But see, our natural mind is, no, not, go walk on some water. I'm going to drown. How you know? Peter got out there, told him, just come. Just come. Now, what makes you think you can't do it? That's a lot of water. Yeah, it is. But why? What? See how we think? We could do the same thing God did. We can. So, saints, I told y'all wasn't going to be long. But just move. That's it. If God tell you to move, move. And believe him. That's all you got to do. I know we don't like to move. Where I'm moving to? He told, I'm going to show you the land. Don't ask him where the land is. He said he's going to show you. Just move. That's all you want to do. Just move. That's it. That's what happened to us. We moved. Now, if you came later, you still move. All the new ones that came in, put your name where Abraham's name is. Abraham's name is. To a land I will show you. The blessing is coming. The blessing is coming. The blessing is coming for us. So I bless you, saints. Thank you for the word. Thank you just for listening. Anyone wants to come to the altar, and the altar is open. Maybe, you know, the Lord is telling you to do, telling you to move. And you just don't have the faith to move, but just move. Thank you. You can pray over the altar, sir.
Father God, as we come before you, humbly bowing our heads, Father, we thank you for your word, Father. We do indeed want to move with your spirit, Lord. We ask that you bless those that are up here at the altar, Father. Do what you do, Father.
Yeah.
Bless those, Father, that wanted to come to the altar, Father. We want to move, Father, in your spirit. There's a movement in this body, Lord, and we want to get in, Father.
Yeah.
Let your spirit rest, rule, and abide, Father. Have your God-like way, Father, in our lives. Touch those deep places, Father, that need to be healed, Father.
Yeah.
We just thank you, Father. We thank you for your first fruit offering, Father.
Yes.
We thank you that we've given our hearts and souls to you, Father, first. And we just thank you, Father. We ask you to continue to bless us, Father, as we leave this place, but never your presence, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. And the church said,
amen.
Holy Heart. Can't you see us coming together, talking about love?
Brother Ken, can you dismiss us, sir?
Father, we thank you for this lesson today. Take the word and just take it home with you. Pray over the church here. Say this in your precious son's name, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Oh.
Thank you.